Hi, boys and girls, Mrs. Baker here. Today I'm going to be teaching you today I'm going to be teaching you all about money. This is one of my favorite things to do in my classroom, and we do it every morning. So I'm so excited to be able to share it with you today. So let's look. First, what we're going to do is we're going to look at each coin. We're going to sing a little song, trying to remember what they're worth and what they look like. And then we're going to do a couple practice rounds of counting money. I'm going to give you some tips and pointers for how to do that, okay? So first off, we have this coin. It's called a penny. In my class, we sing this. Penny, penny, easily spent, copper brown and worth 1 cent. Next, we have the nickel. Nickel, nickel, thick and fat, worth 5 cents. I know that. And the nickel doesn't have any rough edges. It's the smooth coin on the side. That's an easy way to remember which one is the nickel. It's very smooth on the side. Next we have dime, dime, little and thin. I remember you're worth 10. The dime is super small, very thin. And if you feel it on your finger, you can feel little grooves on it. And last we have quarter, quarter, big and bold. You're worth 25, I'm told. The quarter also has the little grooves on the side. I didn't have a song for the dollar, but this year, the kids in my class helped me make one up, so it's pretty awesome. Here it goes. This is a dollar, dollar, long and green. You're worth 100 cents, I mean. So these are the coins and the dollar bill that we use all the time to buy things. When we count money, it's important to first group your coins together so that all the coins that are the same are beside each other. And then when we go to count them, we're always going to start counting with the coins that are worth the most. So we want to put them in order from the coin that is worth the greatest amount down to the smallest amount. So let's do some practice. Let's pretend that you reach down in your coat pocket. Maybe it's your winter coat that you have just had to get out, you know, because it just snowed. And you reach in your pocket, and these are the coins that you find. Not bad, right? So first thing we have to do, put them together so that all alike coins are beside each other. So these are all alike, and these two are alike. So I have two groups. Now we look at those two groups of coins, and we're gonna think, well, which group has the biggest value? I have pennies here, they're worth 1, and these are nickels, and they're worth 5. So 5 is bigger than 1, so we're actually going to flip-flop so that when we start counting, we're going to start counting with our coins that are worth the most. I like to put the amount that my coins are worth. You can do it under or above it. Usually I do it above, but it's easier this way to do it below it. And then we start counting. So when we count money, we're going to start with this first amount. That's the number I'm going to start counting on. Then I'm going to count up by 5 more because I have another nickel. And then we're going to count on by 1s 3 times. So it's going to look and sound something like this. I start counting at 5, 5, count on by 5, 10, count on by 1s, 10, 11, 12, 13. So look at that. You reached into your pocket and you have 13 cents, not bad. To make that cent sign, we just use the letter C and put a line straight through it. Let's try one more. Let's say this time you're sitting on the couch, you reach your hand down in that cushion, and wouldn't you know, you found money. Look at that. And you're thinking, I must be rich. How rich am I? Well, let's figure it out. First step, put the coins in groups. So put them with all of the other ones that are the same. So here I have three different groups, okay? Next, put them in order from the coins that are worth the greatest to least. So I have pennies here. They're worth one. Probably not going to start there. Now I have nickels. Nickels are worth five. Five is bigger than one, so let's flip-flop. And here I have dimes. Dimes are worth 10, which is bigger than 5 and bigger than 1. So they get to hop line and be first. I'm going to write how much they are worth below it. I like to circle them because it looks like a coin. Put them here. Now when we start counting this time, we're going to start counting at 10. We're going to count by tens a couple times. Then we're going to count by fives. Then we're going to count on by ones. It's going to look and sound something like this. 10, 20, 30, 35, 40, 41, 42. So just by sitting on the couch and reaching your hand around, you found 42 cents. Counting money is something that takes time. The more you do it, the better at it you'll get. And you're very lucky because you have expert money counters at your house, your grown-ups. They use money all the time to buy things. Boys and girls, I hope this video helped you. And as you work through your packet, come back to this video for little tips and tricks along the way. Thank you so much for watching. Bye. We'll be right back.